Okay, we're going to be doing the costoclavicular test for thoracic outlet syndrome. It evaluates the neurovascular bundle, and it can compress the subclavian artery and the neurovascular bundle between the rib and the clavicle. So what I'm going to do is get your pulse here. Great. I'm going to bring your arm back, externally rotated. I'm going to have you sit up straight. Great. And I'm looking for recreation of symptoms, loss of pulse. If you don't get a loss of pulse, but you do get symptoms, I would go to the upper limb tensioning test and use those for a peripheral nerve problem related to the brachial plexus. Okay. Okay, we're going to do Adson's thoracic outlet test for the neurovascular bundle that runs the subclavian artery and brachial plexus. So a person that would be having thoracic outlet may be having numbness and tingling in the hand, coldness in the hand, and their hand may get very cold and blotchy and white, lack of circulation. So some of the clinical things you'd find that pins and needles, numbness, paresthesia, cold hand. And so what you got to do is you've got to find the radial pulse. And I got the radial pulse there, very clear. I'm going to bring the arm back into extension and external rotation. I put a little bit of pressure here, but what I want her to do is turn her head towards me, extend the head back a little bit, right there. I want you to take a deep breath. I want you to hold that. And that's going to affect the scalene anterius on this side. Hold that, and the pulse is fine. That's good. You're clear. Good. We're going to do Wright's test. It's another thoracic outlet test, and I'm going to find Megan's pulse, radial pulse. Bring the arm up, externally rotate. Okay, and I'm going to have you turn your head to the right for me. Good, and just hold that. And pulse has diminished a bit. And that affects the pec minor. It compresses the pec minor over the neurovascular bundle. Okay? Good. Okay, again, we're going to do Halsteads Maneuver, which is another thoracic outlet test. Find the radial pulse, bring the arm back. I'm going to rotate your head back here and extend it back a bit. She doesn't have to take a deep breath this time, and this also compresses the scalenes, help to compress the neurovascular bundle as well, this test. Okay, the pulse is good. Okay, we're going to do Speed's test. Speed's is for a tendonitis or tendinosis of the long head of the bicep. So what you want to do is palpate the long head of the bicep in the bicipital groove. You want to bring the arm out. And what I want you to do is I want you to hold that in that position. I'm going to apply pressure in the person's hand has to be in supination and then pronation. I'm going to apply pressure down, but you're going to allow me to push down, but just resist my movement, but allow me to push the arm into extension. First, good, great. Now we're going to bring it back up. We're going to pronate. Feel that. Feel the top of the long head of the bicep. Okay, hold that there, and I'm going to apply pressure down into extension. Great. So reproduction of pain. Okay, let your arm relax. Reproduction of pain in the long head of the bicep to the bicipital groove with the resisted elbow extension, shoulder extension. May show signs of tendonitis or tendinosis of the long head of the bicep. Okay, we're going to do a drop arm test for the rotator cuff, tears in the rotator cuff. It may also show signs of supraspinatus or maybe infraspinatus tendonitis. So what we're going to do is bring the arm up. You passively raise the arm up. It's going to hold here, and then you let the arm go, and you ask the person to slowly lower their arm, slowly lower their arm. And if they can't do that, or they find pain and discomfort, let your arm go, then you'll just passively bring your arm back again. So it's looking for rotator cuff problems, supraspinatus, infraspinatus, tears, and it may also identify some muscle lesions related to the supraspinatus, infraspinatus, in the context of tendonitis. Okay? So we're going to do a Neer's test. Neer's test tests for, it's an impingement syndrome test, though impingement syndrome often means that there's tendonitis of the supraspinatus, maybe the long end of the bicep, or bursa problems in this region. So what you're going to have to do, what you're going to have the person do is immediately rotate their hands with their thumb is towards them. And you're going to bring the arm up in that position, in that plane, bring it up. And if there's pain and discomfort in this region, that would be positive for impingement syndrome. So that's compressing the supraspinatus underneath the acromion process. And the long head of the bicep may also be compressed under the acromion process, creating pain and discomfort. Okay, we're going to do an empty can test, which we're going to bring the arms up in neutral, just straight out like this. And we're testing for a rotator cuff or supraspinatus tear in the tendon or muscle belly. And I'm going to do a little resistive test here, 3 times for 5 seconds. Then I'm going to bring the arms up about 30 degrees or close to the plane of the scapula. Thumbs are going to point down. Okay, and then I'm going to resist test here as well. So if there's weakness, pain, and inability to hold the position, it could be a tear in the supraspinatus muscle or belly, or a nerve problem as well. Okay, we're going to do Hawkins-Kennedy again. Hawkins-Kennedy is an impingement syndrome test, or a test for impingement syndrome. You're trying to compress the long of the bicep under the acromion process or the acromion clavicular ligament. It may also affect the supraspinatus as well. So bring the arm across, you adduct the arm in front of the body, and you do a little medial lateral rotation. And you can do it in different planes. You can do a little lower, a little higher. If the person is having impingement problems of the shoulder with those two muscles, it'll often show itself with this test.